Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain the difference between array list and linked list, and also I will explain the similarities between array list and linked list. So when we can go for the array list and when we can go for the linked list. So then coming to the difference between array list and linked list. So the main difference between array list and linked list is array list internally uses a dynamic array to store the elements. That means due to this dynamic array, the size of the array is increasing and decreasing based on our requirement. But in case of linked list, it uses a double linked list to store the elements. So coming to the next point, if you want manipulate data in the array list, it will take more time, because if you delete element from the array list in the middle of the array list, so we have to shift all the remaining element into a proper position. But if you want to manipulate data in linked list, no need to traverse the memory bits, just we can change the reference link. So if you observe the structure of the array list, so this is the structure of the array list. In the array list, we have a 5 elements in a array list. Suppose I want to delete a 30 from the array list. So after deleting the 30, we have to shift remaining element into a proper position. So it will take more time to shift the elements. But in case of linked list, so if you observe the structure of the linked list, so this is the structure of the linked list. So this is nothing but a node. This is nothing but a data part. This is nothing but a address of the next node. So here we have a 4 elements in a linked list. Suppose I want to delete a 30 from the linked list. So here no need to shift all the elements, just we can change the reference link from second position to fourth position. So here it will take less time to manipulate the data. Then coming to the next point. So array list is better to use when we want store and retrieve the element from the array list object. But in case of linked list is better to use when we want to manipulate the data, we can use the linked list. Array list implements a list interface, so it acts as a list interface because it is getting all the properties from the list interface, and as well as array list is contain its own properties. But linked list implements a list and dequeue interface, so it acts as a list and dequeue interface. So the linked list is containing its initial properties, and also it is getting the properties from list and dequeue interface. So because of this, it acts as a list and dequeue interface. Coming to the similarities between array list and linked list. So array list and linked list both are implement a list interface. So this is the main similarities between array list and linked list. Then coming to the next point, array list and linked list both are maintain a insertion order. That means whatever order we are inserting into the array list or linked list, the same order it will store and we can retrieve. Then coming to the next point, array list and linked list both are not synchronized class. That means multiple threads can perform operation on a both array list and linked list object. Suppose if the object is not synchronized, so we can perform multiple thread can perform operation on a object. But if the object is synchronized, so at a time only one thread can operate. But in case of linked list or a array list, it is a not synchronized class. So because of that, multiple thread can perform operation on a array list or linked list object. Then coming to the when to use array list and when to use linked list. Array list should use whenever we got a requirement to frequently store and retrieve the data from the array list object. But in case of linked list, so we can go for linked list whenever we got a requirement to delete and manipulate the data elements. Then we can go for the linked list. That means, so frequently we are getting the requirement, like we want to manipulate the data from the linked list, then we can go for the linked list. So Friends, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.